Hello, welcome to the fourth of the eight-part video series on how to create a mushroom house. Today, we will build windows and a door using the techniques from our previous videos. To continue where we left off, we have our nice painted terrain, but no way for our forest friends to enter the mushroom. Let's change that. First, let's add some more space to our mushroom stem so we can place the door onto it. I use the same color as the stem and the box mode to build voxels. Once you are done, add a new empty object and hide the terrain. To make our lives easier, we will be using the mirror functionality in the top right corner to build our door. Enable the X-axis or the axis you oriented your mushroom house to mirror any modifications when drawing, painting, or erasing. Go to the last tab in the color palette and use the brown color to create a base. Use the stem as a canvas to draw voxels onto. Now start removing voxels to shape the door you want. Once you are happy, we can add some thickness by double tapping on the object. This is a faster way to add depth. With the same brush, add voxels on the inside of the door so we can paint it. Here I use various shades of brown to enhance the door. Try painting your own or follow along. I would like to add more color to the door to increase the various points of interest in our scene. You can choose one you like, but make sure that it doesn't clash with any other colors. In my case, I chose a blue color and painted using the face mode with color lock enabled to fill a single color. This only works if the colors you used are different, like you see here. During this entire process, I experiment with mix types. You can do the same if you want. Eventually, I painted the door without mirror functionality to give the suggestion of painted wooden planks. Oh, and don't forget to add a door handle or knob like I did. To wrap up the door, I would like to add a small window where we can see a light has been turned on. First, we use the box mode and the bounding box brush to add a frame and add color variation to break up the monotony. To add some light or emission, we need to use a different material with emission enabled. Make sure you change the lighting to blend or physically based in the View Cube menu. Otherwise, there are no differences. To continue, tap on the down arrow in the top left corner of the color palette and select another material. The idea of this system is that you can paint various colors with different material properties. As a side note, keep an eye on which material you are using to avoid redoing or changing your work. Let's go back to the color palette in the first tab and select a yellow color. As a small adjustment to the mushroom stem, I added voxels behind the door to fit the silhouette better. This process is again a back and forth and is different for everyone else. Let's continue and start working on the windows by adding an empty object. Use the bounding box mode again and start creating the outline of the window. Just like the door, add some thickness and filling the inner section. Here I move the window next to the door so we can compare color, shape, proportions, etc. If you want to apply the rotation of an object, you can use Voxelize to set the rotation back to zero. This prevents snapping the 3D view to the object orientation. Keep in mind that voxelizing objects deletes the history. Start adding shading to the window, just like the door. You can use lighter tones on edges that receive light and darker tones in cavities. Same with the door, we are going to add emission colors to the window. At this point, it might be nice to add some flowers or window decorations in the form of a flower box. I encourage you to create your own decorations and experiment away. Once we have one window completed, we can enable the clone button and dragging it to the side. The catch is that cloning is the same as instancing, for those who are familiar in computer graphics. This means that applying a change to one object will be applied to all of them. Keep this in mind when using the clone tool. In the scene properties, you can see ref #26. Meaning a reference to another object. We can make an object unique by detaching it from the other clones. We can do this by holding your pen on the cloned object in the scene properties and select Detach Object. Now we add different flowers or ornaments if you want to. To wrap this video up, we are going to place the windows on the stem of the mushroom. Go ahead and experiment with different ornaments and decorations on the windows or on the mushroom house. In the next video, we will add a pathway to the door using wooden boards and add another mushroom.